I'm telling you now, I mean, that is the best looking, best sounding, coolest operating pedal that we've reviewed all year,
yeah,
maybe even ever. Are you ready?
Hot in here, now it's even hotter.
Right. Chase Bliss.
Whoa.
It's the pedal company that all the cool cats play. It's kind of like, you know when you go into hi-fi shops and you've got all the like the normal stuff and then there's like some unbelievably cool looking hi-fi in the corner that's
with
like
the big speakers like
20,000 quid or something,
yeah,
like that.
For one speaker.
Yeah, and all the cool cats are going, yeah, obviously. Anyway, that's kind of like Chase Bliss are that of the pedal world.
Yeah.
They historically have done some modulations and delays, and they're all kind of crazy and loads of different things, and all the hipsters use them because they're cool.
They sound great as well, do not forget, you know.
Of course, you know, yes.
Joey Landreth, the stuff he gets out of them, just to mention one person,
Clang.
Is incredible.
So, their latest product, the Preamp Mark II Automatone, is a collaboration between Benson, who make a very cool preamp.
Nice to meet you, Benson.
Absolutely. That was, realised that the market for cigarettes had gone, so he separated from Mr. Hedges and thought he'd make guitar pedals instead.
An amplifier.
That won't mean anyone to anyone outside of the UK. So anyway, yeah, but the Benson preamp, which was a very cool standalone pedal preamp. I believe the Chase Bliss guys collaborated with it. I don't know if he's a new member of the team or if he just came in for this.
But Benson makes amps as well. So
yeah, but no, the other guy was the automation guy.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
So, I mean, because, as you'll see with this super, super cool pedal, I mean, apart from the fact that it makes great noises, I mean, who wouldn't want a pedal where the knobs do? Well,
I've got a little blank slider here.
So look at that! Anyway, so you heard Pete play a couple of different sounds there. Let's whiz through. It's actually a really simple,
super simple
pedal, isn't it? This is like, yay, we love those.
Hold to save and hold
absolutely
to do this.
So
and click that.
It's a preamp pedal with fuzz in it as well and some EQ. And I'll go through how you set those up. It has 30 preset locations. So we've got this concept of a clear colored bank, a red bank and a green bank, and basically the idea being once you're in the bank that you want, you can either just scroll through sounds. I know, it's like, it's magic. There's some weird cat wizard in there. What was his name?
It's magic.
Or of course you can do all this via MIDI, because of course if you're a proper cool cat hipster, you'll have a little MIDI switcher as well.
I tried all that. It's pretty simple to do because it comes with a little little thing somewhere where it gives you all the numbers of the CC information and all that stuff. It's not too
it
bad.
Makes even a I very can figure it pleasant out. Change to have a manual printed on two sides of bits of paper, of which actually most of those are kind of just suggested settings for call sounds.
Yeah, it's super duper easy.
Love it. Made by guitar players for guitar players, I would suggest. Yeah, absolutely. It's just a Jack and Jill book. So look, let's whiz over to the one of the banks that don't have anything, or one of the sound, the patches that don't have anything in it. So without pressing any of the buttons, I can set up a basic preamp tone. So I can, you know, I've got volume, treble, parametric EQ, bass and gain. So here we go for a sort of a, you know, here's a sound, and I can show you what the, I'll slide the knobs up and down while you're playing, if that's okay with you.
You can slide the knobs up and down any day.
I was waiting for that. Yeah. Go on. By the way, straight into the front of an amplifier and reverb from the amplifier.
Yeah, so we're using a Lele P split to split into two signals, from one signal into two, into the two amps. Let's put nothing on. Just turn it off for one, please. Back on. I mean, it sounds good. It just.
You don't have to use this into a guitar amplifier. You could use this into straight into some sort of speaker, you know, power amp speaker emulator.
Yeah, like a Strymon Iridium.
Straight into
a
desk,
like,
and then put your speaker emulation on within your recording software. Yeah. You know, but we're using it kind of like, I guess, a traditional
guitar. I want to try that into that little M-box, Cab M.
Cab M.
Yeah.
Yeah, that would work.
Maybe I'll do that when I'm on holiday.
The two notes, Cab M.
Yeah.
Okay, so we've got some cool and multi-purpose buttons along the bottom. Jump, mids, Q, diode, and fuzz. Jump is the easiest one to explain, because you'll notice as you're going through this that... essentially, I'm just preset going, you know, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, and then back to zero again. I can elect to, on any given patch, I can nominate the two presets that it just jumps between. So as you, instead of toggling up, it'll just literally go between like 3 and 7 or whatever you want to do.
Yeah.
So that's all this jump button does. Mids, it's now saying, would you like the mid selected to be off, which I've suddenly realized, of course, as I was playing with the mid-range during that clip a minute ago and thinking, it's not doing very much, is it? That's because I hadn't turned it on. So yes, mids can do nothing, or they can be pre the sort of the gain structure. So here we go. This is what that would be like.
It really pushes the mids as well.
If you do that fast enough, the frequency, it's like a wah-wah.
Well, you can almost use the expression pedal to do that later. Well, maybe, huh?
Or you can go, you can apply the mid control to be post the gain, which means it won't drive the pedal any harder. It'll just simply be a tonal effect after the gain, so.
It's worth mentioning as well, the color of the diode around the knob, or the button, has the same colors marked. So you
That's
can see,
right.
I mean, see the little, so I can't really see from here.
No, you're right, yes. So if it's blue, it's doing the blue writing, and if it's red, it's doing the red writing.
That's what I was trying to
say,
basically.
It's literally,
it's guitar
that's
player.
What guitar players want. The Q, again, Q is the, obviously the mid control is purely and simply a boost and cut.
Boost.
The frequency is electing which frequency, and it's a range of frequencies, like a mid control on a guitar amp would be. It's not a single frequency. And this control here goes from blue to red to black, and that's about how wide is that range of mid-range frequencies that it's adjusting. So I can kind of, again, it's probably more a question of just showing you what that sounds like. So here is right, mid-range preset. So you can hear if you play. That's on its widest setting in terms of the amount of mid-range it brings out. If we go blue, it's a slightly narrower settings. And red is the narrowest setting, so.
Turn the wide on, basically.
Yeah.
On narrow one.
Absolutely. if you decide you would like to activate some of the a different kind of a clipping circuit, you've got you can have the circuit off, which is just a normal transistor, if you like, boost circuit in here. You can elect have a silicon. What did you say?
A JFET.
You can have a silicon version of that or a germanium version. And this is what they sound like. So without, these are the kind of, let's just get sort of some more drivey tones out of this. So lastly, we have a fuzz control here. We can we can elect to add a fuzz circuit in. Effectively, it works as a preamp fuzz circuit, and we don't have to have that switched on. So that's the off mode, or we can have it in an open or a gated mode. Oh. And gated will be that spittier fuzz, and
the
open
Velcro
will be the fatter one. So here, and then of course, again, you can run that. You can elect to run that into your normal transistor diode, which is what the Benson preamp would normally be, or into a silicon or germanium one. So anyway, let's have a little listen how they sound. So let's go with open. Gated.
And then if I turn the volume down, I'll put it back on. Right. We've done three videos now on Fuzzly. I think we're getting into it. Fuzz.
It's addictive. Sucks you in, man.
It sucks you in.
So let's just have a little fiddle. In fact, I tell you what, now that you've got the basic idea, one of the things that we can add in here as well, if you
wish
to.
Here's something we did earlier. Because I did this earlier. There we go. So now on every preset. Come on, Harry. It's Liviosa, not Liviosa.
Hang on. Who was that magician like that fooled the world by saying he could like turn the pages of a book with his mind? Right, it's like.
Yes.
Anyway,
it's apparently,
according to Peter, and I've not read the how to do this yet, but you can assign this to be any one of the sliders if you wish.
Yeah.
So that's kind of cool.
Another thing.
It's a little bit not ideal for this. Demonstration because it actually doesn't really matter, but basically as I want to step through the presets, if I don't have this attached, the game will return to wherever I saved it in the preset.
Yeah.
And if I do have this attached, it will always return to wherever the pedal is set to.
That's why it would be nice to have some kind of MIDI selector switch or something where you program the MIDI so when you click that it'll do that, and then you've got a I fiddled
so
with that yesterday.
Nobody will work that out. Right.
4 hours it took me and I'm still not.
So I'm going to go to the blank. Blankety blank.
Blankety blank. Blankety blank. Blank.
The blank bank. That could have been something else, couldn't
it's
it?
It's the blank bank.
Store that one in the blank bank. Yeah. Apparently.
That's what
anyway,
look,
come
it
on, quickly,
on.
Before we get ourselves into trouble. I'm going to go through the presets now and leave it up to Pete to decide what's appropriate for each preset. So here we go.
This is a bit of
an extreme one, isn't it? Here we go.
That's just a preset from the pedal, right?
Absolutely.
Woo! Oh, that's more funky. More fuzz. What was that there? It sounds great, doesn't it?
I'm telling you now, that is the best looking, best sounding, coolest operating pedal that we've reviewed all year,
yeah,
maybe even ever.
It's pretty damn flipping good, that in every way.
Wicked.
And I like the fact that the presets they've made on here are just good.
Yes.
Because that is just such a turn-off, right? It's good. You're like. I mean,
I don't.
It's great to play, man.
The reason I was looking over there is I'm looking at my pedal board, going, what would I have to take off to fit this on? And I think it's doable.
No, you're not getting it on yours. I'm getting it on mine.
We need shared custody. I think here's
if I have to say something about the pedal, there might be. It's not a negative thing, but if you're a touring musician and you've put that on your pedal board, and you've got people that is putting in your pedal board in and out every night, and you're doing, let's say, 250 gigs a year.
No, you're totally right.
I haven't seen how these sliders and, how the sliders and
stuff.
About
1 in 10,000 of guitarists.
But you know, don't get me wrong. You know, at the moment, nobody's doing any flipping gigs. You know, no one is doing any gigs. You know, but I think that the fact is that it's so. All of this stuff, the sliders and all that stuff, the mechanical of it. I mean, it's a beautiful thing, but I can sometimes I would stand on one of my pedals when I do a solo, you know, because I'll go up and I'll stand on it, right? And then I'm not sure in the.
Maybe it's a studio guy's thing,
I mean,
more.
Dude,
but look, I'm telling you.
I would
now,
have it on my board, I'll be careful
that's
with
That's not
it.
The only. I'm just going to say that there's one last downside with it, or what a negative thing about that. And that is, I'm afraid that this falls into the category of product where if you have to ask how much it is,
yeah,
it probably means you can't afford it.
Yeah.
Bummer. So yes, I'm not going to tell you how much it is because that's the fun part of you either looking through the comments section or diving on over to our website to see how much it is. And then when you come back, you can write how you feel in the comments section.
I bet you there'll be loads of money. Is it not worth the money? Yeah.
Assuming you haven't passed out and fainted.
You have to ask, how much is it? It's like, then you...
It's not a Chinese... You know,
no. That this is there's so much work gone into this pedal. We saw it first at NAMM 2 years ago, was it? Mm. I mean, or maybe I can't remember. Two or three years ago.
But we weren't. They either didn't know much about it, or we got the first proper demo of it this NAMM, didn't
we?
But
and we literally just received that, and I plugged it in the first time. I was like, this is just.
I think it's
incredible.
Wicked. I absolutely think it's. I mean, again. We did the video of, I don't know whether that's out yet or to come out yet, but we did the video of a product called a Poly Digit this morning, the Bebo and the Digit.
Yeah.
Phenomenal piece of audio equipment, you know, phenomenal. But the user interface was just... complicated.
I think some people will like it.
Some
people will go, yes, come on, let's
maybe
do
not
this.
Maybe the depth of complexity that the pedal was capable of doing
was,
and it was just like, oh my God. It's like, you know, but this is just like.
But some of the Chase Bliss pedals, which we've tried to review in the past, where you have little dip switches in the back.
Oh, for sure.
And you're like, holy, what's going on? I don't think I can get all of this stuff. You know, yeah. I think.
But that was a lot of that was on an older Chase Bliss products. It is, it's the similar kind of thing in the sense of you, it's all about assigning a MIDI channel to one of the switch, to one of the
one parameters. Of the things does the, yeah, but yeah.
Because stuff doesn't move as you change it. It's sort of, they almost need to revisit every single Chase Bliss pedal and make it in that format, don't they? So that, can you imagine that, having like a whole board of these doing different things and you press one thing and it just creates like a tidal wave in the space-time continuum.
Old Bang & Olufsen system. Do you remember the old Beogram Bang & Olufsen systems that were like that, and you open up and the thing came out, oh my God. It's very cool and it sounds great. And yeah, you're going to have to fight me for it, I think.
Or Chase Bliss can just send us another one. Make us happy bunnies and we can have one each. But that's wicked.
It is great. It sounds bloody amazing.
We've done nothing to this sound. That is literally two clean valve amplifiers and that pedal, and obviously a reasonably good guitar player.
Why don't we, look, let's just, this is the first time we do this.
Yeah, we have to,
so here we go.
Responsible through the, and through the protective perspex screen.
And it's all right with the alcohol on this guitar because it's mine, so that's fine. See, this is the cable.
This is what happens though. This was a brand new black guitar just before I touched it with my hand sanitizer on. I'm going to go through the same settings you went through, Pete, but maybe not for as long to stop the audience from the pain. As well, in terms of like,
that mid, see the blue mid is on.
Yeah.
And if you try to take that down, just turn the knob down. Yeah. And then try it now. That mid, you know, you're pushing those mid.
You could do this all day.
I know, absolutely. Do you want to show people how quick it is to save something as well? As soon as you hold it down.
I will finish the demo, Pete, by showing the people how quick it is to save something. So what you do to save is you go, meh, 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 turn the things off, whatever. Hold this down. number flashes, it's saved. You see, look, I'll go all the way back to number 9 and that's where we'll be. Ta-da!
Super simple. Yeah, so go and buy one of these.
It literally is. It's yeah. It's product of the, what a way, I'm going on holiday tomorrow. What a way to finish what has been a fairly long and arduous period of time at Andertons here. But yeah, Pete's going on holiday too.
Yeah.
So we're having a couple of weeks off.
We're not going together though.
We're not going together, no. Not to that little nudist camp in Bournemouth that we used to go to together before we were married. Don't worry, we stored up lots of videos so you won't even notice that we're gone.
And then we'll be back, yes, and we're probably looking even more haggard.
You'll notice when I'm back because hopefully I'll have a jolly nice suntan. Anyway, right, onwards and upwards. Wicked.
That's cool, man.
Chase Bliss.
Automatone. Automatone. Automatone!
Automatone.
Yeah, automatone.
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 Right, okay, bye.
Bye.
Thanks for watching.